There are two types of people who go to the doctor, those who hate shots, and actually, there's only one type, because everybody hates needles, right? Well, now injections in your arm are finding strength in numbers. You might soon avoid the flu because of hundreds of needles in you. Here's Adam Yamaguchi to explain.
Getting vaccines and other important inoculations are all part of protecting your body from disease and building immunity against harmful viruses. Luckily, a team at the Georgia Institute of Technology is striving to find a less painful way to deliver these life-saving medicines.
We're motivated to do that in part because vaccines are often given to kids who don't like the needle stick so much. We're also motivated because people in this country as well as around the world don't always have sufficient access to healthcare personnel administering vaccines, and so this is a very simple way to administer them.
He's talking about this, a small patch with not just one needle, but 100 of them, each one dissolving into your skin after applying the patch with little to no discomfort. I headed south to Atlanta, Georgia to meet Mark Prausnitz, a Regents professor of biomolecular engineering at Georgia Tech, to learn more about the development of these microneedle patches.
Welcome to Georgia Tech, Adam. Let's look at some microneedles.
Great.
So in fact, here I've got some pulled up on the screen.
Several times magnified, I would imagine.
Just a few times magnified, and in fact, if we see the real thing,
oh, wow.
It just looks like that. So that little square in there is where all of those microneedles are.
How many needles are in this little patch here?
There are 100 needles, 10 by 10.
Wow.
The microneedles are as tall as just a few hairs are thick.
How exactly does this work?
You take this patch, you would apply it to the wrist.
Mm-hmm.
So press it here to the wrist, you push down firmly, then you leave it in place for a few minutes. When you're done, you can peel it off and throw it away.
So inside each of these needles is the medication?
That's right. Here are some microneedles before use. We then press them into the skin for 5 minutes, pull them out, and they're gone.
They just disappear.
A nice feature here is that there are no needles there when you're all finished, and that's an important safety advantage.
The main purpose of this is to administer drugs. What is the alternative to this?
Well, the alternative typically is a hypodermic needle. So, you know, something like that. So that, of course, hurts a bit scary. And it's also something you can't usually administer to yourself. So that's another important feature, is that you can put a patch on all by yourself. People don't describe it as painful. Some people describe it like if you took some Velcro and pressed that against your skin, there's kind of a roughness that you can feel. So that's the kind of sensation.
Before you landed on this, what were some of the prototypes like?
When we first started out, we used silicon wafers, just like are used in the microelectronics industry. But silicon's really not the best medical material, so we moved to stainless steel, what hypodermic needles are made out of. And we then made a patch that looks something like this. And you can see now a close-up of the microneedles, which are made out of water-soluble materials, like sugar is one of our favorite materials to use.
One of Mark's last big hurdles is figuring out how to mass produce millions of medically safe microneedles.
The flu vaccine patch, we hope, will be available within the next 5 years.
And the sooner the better, for all of us.